If you struggle with anxiety, then you know that it can range from being a small nuisance in your life all the way down to being completely disruptive and debilitating. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh, and I want to share with you the number one mistake that people make when they're treating their anxiety. And of course, sometimes the mistake is made simply because they don't know about the entire picture when it comes to anxiety. Other times it's because they don't understand. And I want you to fall into the category of a person who knows and is aware and understands the underlying mechanisms of anxiety so you can treat it, conquer it once and for all, and get back to living the life that you love and that you deserve. This video comes from my heart, and I struggled with toxic mold poisoning for many years. Of course, I didn't know I was being poisoned, and once I found out, I couldn't figure out how to make myself well. But during that time, my nervous system went into autonomic nervous system dysfunction because it was fighting poisons on a minute-by-minute basis. And because of that, it made it so that my thinking became more hypervigilant. I would ruminate. I mostly was focused on my health anxiety, which is now a category of a certain type of anxiety. But the point is, my brain was running hot because I was being toxified. And at the same time, I had a big problem that I had to solve. And I know firsthand how that can feel, and I do not want you to stay in that place for long. So let me share with you the number one mistake. What people don't understand is that anxiety at its core is a brain dysfunction or dysregulation. We know from a plethora of science that there is a dysregulated brain pattern, one of autonomic nervous system dysfunction, that is at the core of anxiety. It's essentially a brain pattern that's running very fast. It's a brain that's using excessive high beta, that's the name of it, extra fast speed. So in my case, when I was suffering from toxic mold poisoning, my brain actually never used excessive high beta. My brain, she got stuck using excessive beta, low beta, which is the speed of thinking. So I was caught in constant hypervigilance. Thankfully, it never led to constant fight or flight. Now, if you're stuck in high beta, and if you've struggled with anxiety for a long time, and of course, the further your anxiety is down on the continuum, if you feel anxious on a daily basis, if you can't turn that thinking off in your brain, if you are on red alert or micro or mini fight or flight, or even actual fight or flight, then your brain is stuck somewhere in the betas from low to high. And that brain pattern, being stuck in it, it's kind of like when a car that has a manual transmission is stuck in overdrive. It's not easy to unstick that gear from the one that your brain is using back down to the healthy gears of alpha and low beta. So the idea is, it's time to shift your brain out of anxiety mode into the mode of calm focus. And a number one mistake that people make is they don't understand this. They don't get that there's measurable science that says that if you struggle with anxiety, it's because your brain is stuck in the mode of excessive extra fast speed that leads to those feelings of anxiety. And again, for myself, I would always think it's my lifestyle because I have 5 kids, I own my own business, I'm a very busy person. So I would kind of self-blame my lifestyle for the symptoms that I was having. If I could just chill out more, I would feel better and I wouldn't feel so ramped up. But through my journey of toxic mold poisoning, what I now know is that I couldn't chill out. My nervous system was stuck. So even when I would intentionally sit and relax, my system couldn't come down because it was stuck. And of course, I doubled down on using the strategies that I know once I realized what the underlying mechanism was. So The strategies that I know to use are called neurofeedback brain training. And of course, it's coupled with lifestyle change because that side of the street does matter. But more importantly, there's technology that exists that can unstick your brain, shift you out of high beta, and get you back to that optimal brain pattern of calm focus. Now, this is the cruel joke about anxiety, is that when you're stuck in that mode, it makes it really difficult for you to do the things that you need or you want to unstick yourself. The technology makes it easy. It unsticks your brain for you, which enables you to do all the other things. So as I was caught in this, trying to figure out how to get better, doing all these other things, going to doctors, I stopped for a moment. And in that moment of clarity where my brain was using a slower speed, I thought to myself, stop running around doing all these things. It's making the problem worse. Start using the brain training headband and the professional neurofeedback app. Start using neurofeedback. So, of course, I did. And a month later, my brain was in a completely different spot. But it took me a beat, even me, to be able to go stop the running around, start using the tech that you know works. And of course, I've always used it. So I've always used neurofeedback, which I literally give it all the credit in the world for not making me as sick as I could have been and I would have been had I not had a consistent neurofeedback habit. I know that. I believe that sincerely, and I've been able to measure my brain all along. The reason it eluded me is because my brain pattern wasn't that bad, but what I didn't realize is it was giving me the ramped up feeling that I had, even though it could have been much, 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 much worse. So the idea is my consistent habit was one of someone who has a healthy brain pattern and is maintaining that for calm focus. So when I double down, I use the system more and I use the system consistently. So I was able to create that big shift over a month. That's what neurofeedback can do for you. The way that it works is you put the system on and you do a session. You don't walk around with it. People ask me that a lot. You do a session calmly, quietly in your sanctuary chair. And as you're doing the session, there's nothing you need to do except for relax. And when you relax, it creates more neuroplasticity in your brain pattern. It breaks that neurorigidity and that stuckness of being in high beta so that your brain can change and shift with ease. It's a passive treatment. You don't have to think about it. That's why it works. So if you're interested in exploring the neuroscience behind anxiety and being able to see how your brain is performing, there's two levels of brain training that I offer. The highest top tier level starts with a qEEG brain map. That's a way that you can assess your brain at home. Now everything is advanced, so you can do this at home. It shows up in my online portal and in the specialized app. Then I'm able to analyze it and we spend an hour together over Zoom. You've also filled out an intake. I know about your lifestyle and your history. I can connect the dots for you between what you've been experiencing symptomatically and how your brain is performing. And most importantly, I can give you a plan moving forward. That plan moving forward is individualized, professional, top-tier neurofeedback with me and my team. So there's a team of coaches who help you. And that way we can address not only your brain performance, but be able to make sure we're synergizing your mind and your body so that you can feel and perform so much better in just a few months. That's our top tier service. It starts with the qEEG brain map over at drtrishleigh.com. So please go over to drtrishleigh.com. Don't make the mistake that so many other people make that keeps them stuck in anxiety, keeps them either just mildly ramped up or paralyzed with crushing anxiety that does not allow them to be on purpose. I want you to be on purpose. I want you to be able to get back to work, back to school, back to friendships, back to relationships, back to hobbies, back to life. Okay, if you're ready for it, Meet me over at drtrishlee.com. And as always, control your brain or it'll control you.